to say you're welcome here. You can be happy now that you're home. We're all a part of one world. We all can share. It's horrible to think that my kids are always hungry.
And this is the first time I've lived in poverty with my children. They always had everything, didn't need for nothing.
I never thought it could get this way. It's been like this for a while. And self-esteem-wise, it hurts.
Hunger is caused primarily by economic issues. There's a lot of people living in poverty in Central Florida. Over 350,000 people are living at the poverty level. And for a family of four, that's roughly $19,000 a year. How can you make ends meet there?
Here you are.
What do you say, you guys?
Thank you.
All of you.
This is what I need for my family.
Here you are.
So they go on. Bills are just, they're the basics. We take care of the basics, and it never seems to be enough. So it makes it really hard to sit there and say, oh, do we have money for food this week? Do we not? How am I gonna do this? You know, it makes it difficult to sit there and say, I can't even provide the basics for my children for, you know, food. It makes it very hard. It ends up being that the food is our last priority. Sad to say, but that's true.
Yeah, too much month at the end of the money? Yeah, that's a reality. You know, and that goes to play with how they plan their meals. You know, going for the high starch, high caloric foods that are, you know, more affordable.
I know we're not getting adequate nutrition. It's cheaper to buy the junk than it is to buy good food.
Better snack, maybe nutritious.
Thank you. Someone just needs to explain to me why in the wealthiest and most technologically advanced country in the history of the world, we would allow a child to go without the basic necessities of life and maybe lose hope that life won't get better at some point. We're better than that.
Typical client here has an income of between $7,000 and $9,000 a year, usually on disability. These are people who are not lazy. They're not lazy. Many of them want to work, but they can't work because they're physically disabled.
I appreciate all the help, and it really helps me out quite a bit.
It's an essential part of life, and these people here are short on essentials of life.
Good morning.
Good morning. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome. Hope you enjoy.
I will.
This assistance from the Meals on Wheels is a great, great blessing. Real great blessing. We appreciate it very much.
Sometimes we're the only person they see for the entire day.
They need to be on the lookout for old folk because it gets lonely if you don't have somebody. And We manage, I guess that's the best word, because our wants are not great.
We're gonna have good supper tonight. Look at that, that looks, ooh.
He's been
good
serving for such a long time and now to have to receive, but he is humble and receptive to receiving. It doesn't seem to get him down that he does it, and he and his wife make such a lovely team supporting each other.
My wife was beginning back then, a couple of years ago, with old timers. It was getting kind of hard for us to get the meal, a good meal, warm meal, every day. But I never thought that I would be looking forward to getting a meal like that, or I would be given food like that. But now that we're at this stage of the life, we appreciate it. It's a blessing, a real blessing. This way I know I'm not going to go hungry tonight.
It feels good when you need the help and you're down and you don't think that anybody else could understand.
I'd rather be on the other side, like be on your side, and end up giving to the people and feel good about it, you know, not being where I am today, you know. It doesn't feel right.
Nobody should go hungry. There's a lot of waste.
Thank you for your help!
What's my favorite meal? All of it.
Right.
Food.
Truer words could not be spoken.